Okay, welcome to the recording for the second half of Chapter 9, IRAs and SEPs. So we talked about, in the first half of class, we talked a lot about the traditional IRAs. This was a very good slide just to kind of get caught up to where we were. This is a very good slide where you compare qualified plans with IRAs, SEPs, simples, and 403Bs. And we'll be getting to 403Bs, simples and 403Bs in the next chapter. We looked at the contribution limits for both traditional and Roth and catch-up. We said that you have to have earned income to make IRA contributions, with the exception of spousal contributions. Excess contributions subject to the 6% tax. We went through that phase-out exercise where we drew the line on the board to see how phase-outs work. And there were two phase-outs for married people. One, if you have one spouse who is an active participant and another spouse who is not an active participant, there are two potential phase outs. It could be from 96 to 116 and 181 to 191. So here are some examples of that, and I went over even more examples in class. We talked about the saver's credit. And then we talked about how distributions are taxed from traditional IRAs. It's ordinary income is the general rule, but you can make after-tax contributions to traditional IRAs. So the answer to the question, can you contribute to a traditional IRA, is always yes. It's just a matter of fact of whether the deduction, the contribution is going to be tax deductible and to what extent. So, assuming that you have some after-tax basis in the account, there's a ratio of the after-tax basis before withdrawal over the fair market value of the account at withdrawal. We talked about RMD rules in Chapter 7, 59. You need to take a RMD is if you don't take it out before then, it's too late, so you can't take it out before 59.5. There's a penalty for early. There's a penalty for late, which is after age 70.5 on traditional IRAs and in qualified plans. So here are the exceptions to the early withdrawal penalties, and I think this was one of the last things that we covered in class. And again, I wanted to point out to you to make the comparison. Here's the exception from Chapter 7 for the early withdrawal penalty, which is 10% prior to age 59.5. By the way, the penalty for taking it out too late is 50%, not just 10%. So look at compare qualified plans here in Chapter 7 to this list. You will be tested on this. Okay, let's go ahead and get into the new stuff, getting into the second half of this chapter. Roth IRAs